leading in the world of, I would call it, biohacking.
You could call it that.
We can call it this way. Mm-hmm. So that's what we heard, because you're hacking babies. Can you explain a little bit the process in general, of course, and we'll take it on from there.
The process of...
No, the idea of this new way of hacking, you know, how is this going? How is this happening? Why is it really today a trend? Or
the essential story of this moment of humans on Earth is that we have these two new superpowers, human-engineered intelligence and human re-engineered biology, and they're connected to one another. And with these tools, humans are increasingly able to edit life. And it's starting very simply. And so the world's first CRISPR babies were born in China in 2018. We've been genetically engineering crops, depending on how you see it, for maybe 50 years or maybe for 10,000 years, depending on your definition. We're at the era of new healthcare applications. And so the first people who've been cured of sickle cell disease through gene therapies already exist and have benefited from these technologies. People go straight to these dystopic things of Brave New World or 1984, or whatever, and certainly we should be afraid of those kinds of things. But what we're talking about is, can we do healthcare better? Can we do agriculture better? Can we grow more crops on less land while protecting our environment? If we have an embryo that would end up dying of a genetic disease as a young child, can we edit that embryo early on to prevent that kind of future?
Indeed. How is AI today playing a role in all of this?
So essentially what AI does, it lets us see patterns in complex systems.
Okay.
And the more that we can see those patterns, the more that we can understand these complex systems, the more that we can derive insights, and the more that we can intervene.
Definitely. So I know there's a book that you're a publisher, and then you're signing a book here.
Yes, e-book. Yes.
So tell us a little bit about it.
And so the book Superconvergence. It's Superconvergence, and then after the colon, how the genetics, biotech, and AI revolutions will transform our lives, work, and world. It's published June 11th in the United States, but there'll be language translations around the world. And it's essentially this story of human-engineered intelligence and re-engineered biology and what it's going to mean for the future of life. So I talk about the nature of change. I talk about the applications. I talk about the worst-case scenarios and things that we should be afraid of. And then I talk about, well, what is it going to take to build the best possible future? And I lay out a framework for trying to achieve
that. So that's it. June, Amazon?
Anywhere, books are sold.
Wherever it's available. So don't forget to grab a copy. And with that, I'd like to really thank you, James.
Thank you so much.
For this innovative way of doing things and then possibly helping humanity in one way or another.
That's the goal. I mean, these technologies have scary applications. And we should imagine the worst applications. But we should also imagine the best applications. Say, well, what's the difference between the best and the worst? And our goal is, how do we deliver the best to the best of our bills? All right, my friend.
That's it.